DAX offers you a set of time intelligence functions whose goal is to retrieve the beginning or the end of a given period. All these functions read the content of the filter context, and then they retrieve they return a table containing only one date, and this date is either the beginning or the end of the current selection. Let's see that with an example. If the filter context contains one date only, the 12th of May 2020, end of month returns the end of May, whereas start of month returns the beginning of May. End of quarter returns the end of June, that is the quarter to which May belongs to, and start of quarter returns the 1st of April, the beginning of the current quarter. Start of year and end of year, they always return the 1st of January and the 31st of December of the current selection, where by selection we mean the content of the filter context. Keep in mind, all these functions return a table, so the result is a table to make them convenient to use as calculate filters. This is how they behave when the filter context contains one date only. What happens if the filter context contains multiple dates, so a selection containing a set of dates? In that case, this function works using the first or the last date of the current selection. So if the selection contains from the 12th of May up to the 20th of July 2020, end of month returns the end of July, that is, the end of the month to which the last day belongs to. Start of month returns the beginning of May. Start of quarter returns the 1st of April, that is the quarter of May, and end of quarter returns at the end of September, so the end of the quarter to which the last day belongs to. Start of year and end of year, they do not change because they still go up to the 1st of January to the 31st of December of the current year. Let's now see their behavior using some queries. Here in the first query, we do a calculate table and we compute the end of month of the date. We just compute the end of month of the date. The selection contains one date only, which is the 12th of May 2020. If I run the query, the result is the 31st of May 2007. You see that the result is a table. If a calculate table returns a table, and end of month returns a table. If instead of using end of month, we use start of quarter, that will be the beginning of the quarter to which May belongs to. And if I run it, the result is the 1st of April 2007. If the selection contains a set of dates, like in this example where I'm using all the dates between the 2 of May 2007 up to the 12, sorry, from the 2, from the 5 of February up to the 12th of May 2007, the result of end of month will consider May as the month. And you see that we have the 31 of May. If instead of using start end of month, we use start of month, and we run it again, now the result contains the 1st of February, so the beginning or the end of the current selection, whatever the selection is. As we said, an important detail is that all these functions are table functions. Their result is a table. And the reason is they are designed in order to be used as filter arguments of calculate. You will typically use this function using calculate, whatever measure, followed by start of quarter, end of month, or whatever time intelligence function filtering the date. This start of quarter returns a table that is then used by calculate to filter the date so that only the 1st of April will be visible while sales amount is being computed. In the example, we execute the code inside another calculate. You typically do not have this outer calculate because this is the filter context coming from the Power BI report or whatever client tool is setting the filter context where your calculation happens. The results are the sales in the 1st of April 2009. Another important detail that is valid for all time intelligence functions is that when you write start of quarter date date, you are using a column reference. But actually, these functions receive a table as their first argument. Using start of quarter date date is nothing but syntax sugar for the more complex expression, which is the one actually executed, which is start of quarter calculate table distinct date data. So the engine will actually execute this code even though you write the simpler version. This is important because calculate is there and context transition might happen. So you need to be aware that executing these functions in a row context triggers context transition, and this might lead to unexpected results you need to be aware of.